In our videos, we've repeatedly talked about the most unusual animals on the planet. Moreover, different issues included both extinct and currently existing species. But every time while preparing for the next video, we make sure that we've not introduced you to even a small part of the unique animals. After all, evolution sometimes follows the most unconventional paths, forcing animals to acquire bizarre appearances or special adaptations. And despite all their strangeness, all these features have led to the fact that unusual-looking animals only win in the competition for a place in the sun. Today, we've prepared another batch of stories about the most amazing animals in the history of the Earth. Subscribe to the Age of Dinosaurs channel. This will allow you to not only learn a lot about the evolution of life on Earth, but our subscribers will be the first to know about the release of new videos. You all can help promote the channel with your comments and likes as well. Mary River Turtle. This unique turtle was described by scientists only in 1994, although by this time it's one of the most popular pets among Australian lovers of these amphibians for about 20 years. Turtle researcher John Kann became interested in the hatchlings being sold in Sydney for home aquariums. After much searching, he discovered that they were sourced from the Brisbane region. It turned out that this turtle lives only in the Mary River in Queensland. At the same time, it's the largest freshwater turtle in the world, but by the time it was discovered, it could already be included in the Red Book. Due to market demand, this turtle's egg-laying was mercilessly plundered. They acquired the ability to reproduce only at the age of 25 years. This led to a sharp decline in the natural population. As an adult, this turtle has a streamlined, low shell, elongated neck, and webbed hind feet. Notably, it's one of several species of turtles that breathe through the cloaca. There, they have special glands that allow them to absorb oxygen from the water. This feature allows them to stay underwater for up to 72 hours. Another notable feature of Mary River turtles is their distinctive hairstyle. As they age, algae settles on their shell and head, making their appearance very diverse and unusual. Pike blenny. This unusual fish lives along the Pacific coast of North and Central America. They live in holes at the bottom. It can also use empty shells or even discarded glass bottles as shelters. The pike blenny is the largest representative of its family. It can grow up to 30 centimeters in length. You can recognize it by its inconspicuous grayish-brown color, thin elongated body, and large head. There's a long fin on their back, and closer to their head, there's a small appendage resembling a bang. The unusualness of this bottom-dwelling fish lies in the structure of its mouth parts. This is especially pronounced in males. Their jaws, studded with sharp long teeth, can open in all directions. At the same time, the dog behaves very aggressively. They're capable of attacking an enemy that's larger in size. The dog's not shy about biting scuba divers. It's not fatal, but very painful. Also, with the help of their mouths, male pike dogs sort out relationships among themselves. They also guard the fertilized eggs until the fry hatch. Okapi. This unique ungulate lives only in the jungles of the Republic of Congo in Central Africa. At the moment, there's only about 25,000 of them left, and they're listed in the Red Book. The okapi is the only surviving member of the giraffidae, other than the giraffes themselves. Outwardly, these animals resemble a bizarre cross between a giraffe and a zebra. Their legs have a characteristic striped color, their muzzle is lighter, and the rest of their body is dark in color. This forest giraffe grows up to 1.7 meters at the shoulders and about 2 meters in length. They weigh up to 250 kilograms. Their neck isn't as long as that of their closest relatives, but in terms of tongue length, they're in no way inferior to a giraffe. With its help, okapi can lick its own eyes. These animals are very shy and cautious. It's noteworthy that they communicate with each other using low-frequency sounds, elusive to the human ear. They were first described in 1901, but photographs in the wild were taken using a camera trap only in 2008. About 100 of them currently live in zoos around the world. Irrawaddy Dolphin. Despite the fact that these cetaceans are dolphins, they're very different in appearance from most of their relatives. They live in Southeast Asia, mainly in the Mekong River Delta. Moreover, some dolphins never enter rivers, while others never go out to sea. Based on this characteristic, scientists have divided Irrawaddy dolphins into two separate subspecies. But that's not what makes them remarkable. A distinctive feature of Irrawaddy dolphins is the complete absence of a beak. They can also be recognized by a small dorsal fin located closer to the tail. In Cambodia and Laos, these dolphins are considered sacred animals. For a long time, they've been helping local fishermen to drive schools of fish into nets, but it's precisely this feature that's the reason for the gradual extinction of the species. Young dolphins can't always orient themselves correctly during the hunt and often get entangled in nets. Now, there's only about 200 of these dolphins left, and about the same number of related Australian snub-nosed dolphins. Glaucus nudibranch. This type of nudibranch mollusk differs from its relatives in that it lives not on the bottom, but on the surface of the water. They're sometimes mistakenly called blue dragons, but they're a slightly different species of mollusk. Nudibranches are commonly called blue caps, sea damselfishes, or even sea rockets. They float on water due to surface tension. Glaucus can also swallow an air bubble and thus maintain its buoyancy. It's also noteworthy that these creatures are hermaphrodites, but they still need a partner to mate. They mate on the ventral side, and then both mollusks lay eggs. They're interesting not only for their appearance, but also for some behavioral features. Many of the marine organisms it feeds on are poisonous, but the sea swallow is not only resistant to strong poisons, but also knows how to accumulate them in its body, and also poison the victim when it bites. But this mollusk is completely safe for humans. The most interesting prey of this creature is the Velella jellyfish, or swallowtail. She's also unique in her own way. Externally, this jellyfish resembles a round raft with a small sail. It moves along the surface of the water, and many marine inhabitants travel on its back. The sea swallow also does the same, but if necessary, it also gradually eats its transport. Glass frogs. Unique frogs with a transparent abdomen were discovered at the end of the 19th century by the Spanish zoologist Marcos Jimenez de la Espada. From above, they look like ordinary frogs, but if you look at them from below, you can see all the internal organs in detail and even observe the process of egg growth. Also, in some species, the skin on the paws is transparent. Today, they're classified into a separate family, consisting of 12 genera and 60 species ranging in size from 3 to 7.5 centimeters. All glass frogs live in Central and South America. A distinctive feature of this family is that the eyes are directed forward rather than located on the sides of the frog's head. They live in trees and only come close to water to lay eggs. Moreover, they attach it to plants and stones near waterfalls or above ponds. Scientists believe that in this way, frog eggs are protected from being eaten by predatory fish. It's also noteworthy that Japanese scientists were able to breed completely transparent frogs. This was done in order to study the process of organ formation and the course of various diseases, including the growth of cancerous tumors. For the experiments, they used a local brown frog. The transparency gene for her is recessive. But when crossing two individuals with recessive genes using artificial insemination, it was possible to obtain transparent tadpoles. As they develop, scientists can observe the process of transformation into an adult from the inside, but their offspring are no longer viable. Scientists also stated that, if necessary, they can also breed luminous frogs. Smallmouth macropina. Continuing the glass theme, we'll tell you about another transparent creature. This deep-sea fish was accidentally caught in a fishing net back in 1939, and since then, its structure has haunted scientists. It's clear that their head was a transparent dome, but it was damaged in the process of being lifted from the depths due to a pressure difference. It was only possible to obtain a photograph of a smallmouth macropina in its natural habitat in 2004. And in 2009, we managed to catch several specimens and place them in an aquarium. And this fish presented scientists with many surprises. It lives at a depth of 500 to 800 meters, and possibly even deeper. Its habitat includes the waters of the Pacific Ocean near the coasts of Japan, Canada, and the USA, as well as the Bering Sea and the Kuril Islands. It turned out that this fish, about 15 centimeters long, has more than just a transparent head. Her eyes are located inside this dome and, if necessary, can look both forward and upward. Macropina looks out for prey above itself through a transparent dome, and then assumes a vertical position and grabs it. At this moment, the eyes shift 90 degrees. Due to the small size of the mouth opening, the fish can only feed on zooplankton, small fish and crustaceans. Its diet also includes poisonous siphonophores. It's possible that the eyes are covered under a dome to protect them from attacks from their tentacles. We'd like to thank everyone who watched this episode to the very end. If you're interested in learning more about other modern and extinct animals, we recommend checking out our past videos on the Age of Dinosaurs channel. They also talk about the problems of modern society and the relationship of humanity with nature.